I've heard from the hospital, Judy, and you are to be admitted tomorrow. Now, there is absolutely nothing for you to worry about.
You've got to be kidding.
Don't be silly, Judy. You're not going to die.
Oh, you can guarantee that, can you?
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Trouble is, the old knees aren't as good as they used to be. Sorry. Tell you what, I'll sing you a hymn, eh? I know this one. Onward, Christian soldiers, marching as to war.
And this is where you get yours.
Fletcher, you all right?
Just as well we decided to keep an eye on you, don't you think?
I didn't even know that he and Michael knew one another.
You only met Butler on the one occasion before that?
Yes, that's right.
Well, that's all we need for now. There'll be no need for us to keep you under surveillance any longer.
Well, what about the reporters? They've been driving me crazy. Can't you make them leave me alone?
Well, they're hungry for a scandal, and they smell one here.
I'd be better off back inside Wentworth. At least I wouldn't be hounded there.
It'll certainly be some time before this lot blows over. I think they'll be camping on your doorstep for some time.
Wentworth Detention Centre.
Meg, it's Jim.
Well, what's happened, Jim? Have they caught Michael?
Yes, it's all been sorted out.
Oh, so they've got him then?
Yeah, it's all over. Look, Meg, could you tell Mrs. Davidson I'll be returning to work the day after tomorrow?
So soon? Oh, but, Jim, I don't think you...
Just give Mrs. Davidson the message, please.
This door comes into the garden, we might get the drum on that Kerry.
Yeah, well, I'd certainly like to know it was in those suitcases.
Geez, they were heavy. Oh, the wicked may prosper on earth, but they'll certainly rot in hell.
Yeah, well, I think we all will. I'm not sure about prospering on earth either. Maybe I'm not wicked enough.
Shouldn't talk like that, B.
You know, I think perhaps this Kerry's got the right idea. It's like Ken says. The way to beat the system is to appear to go along with it, make it work for you. Seems like that's what she's doing.
She certainly gets enough privileges from the screws.
Well, as long as she's not paying for it by lagging, good luck to her. Maybe we should take a leaf out of her book.
How?
Well, I've been thinking it's a shame to let all the good that Ken's done go to waste. Why don't we keep on with this acting business?
Yeah, well, I'll be in that.
What about the rest of you? You want to keep up with the acting stuff?
Yeah.
Well, then why don't we put a play together of our own?
Nothing like that one we did last Christmas.
No, that is not the way to beat the system.
Ken really got through to you about that, didn't he, Bea?
Yeah, well, makes sense, doesn't it?
Something you ought to know, Bea.
Yeah, what's that? I've
been talking to Kerry, that new girl.
I thought you'd be able to tell us something about her.
Yeah, well, she's a painter. Think she's it in a bit.
A painter?
Yeah, you know, paints pictures. She's doing one out there now. It doesn't look like anything I've ever seen. Anyhow, she's going to do some, you know, for showing to the public.
Oh, so that's why the screws are making all the fuss about her. Sounds like she's quite a celebrity.
Yeah, she's real matey with your Ken.
He's not my Ken. What do you mean, real matey?
Well, they're on together for sure. Sounds like he's the one who arranged for her to come down from Barnhurst so they could see each other more, I reckon.
Well, we can forget about the play. I'm not going to have nothing to do with anything that he does. Two-timer.
No, we're still doing it.
But you are going to show her a thing or two, aren't you, Bea?
Oh, shut up about it. Come on, let's talk about the play.
Hello.
What do you want?
I want you to reclaim my bail money.
You what?
I can't take the harassment I'm getting from reporters, and I don't want to be in your debt any longer.
That'd be great, wouldn't it? You'd be back in Wentworth. I'd be seeing you every day, remembering... Carol, your trial's only a few days away. Can't you wait till then?
I just don't want you to hate me.
Don't hate you. It's just... Get out of here!
I'm sorry.
Just go away, Carolyn. Please.
That's a pretty mess.
Yeah, it'll clean up all right.
Will it just?
Yeah, you won't even notice it.
You won't get a shower or breakfast until every single spot of paint's off that floor.
What?
You heard me. Come with me and get some cleaning materials. I don't want a single mark left.
You're joking. What does a bit of splash paint matter?
I don't know what sort of pigsty you're used to. But in here, the cells are kept clean. Spotlessly clean.
Yeah, that'd be antiseptic if it wasn't for the screws.
Shut up, Smith. Come with me, Vincent.
Well, that's the way you get your kicks.
You just watch yourself. You'll soon learn that you're not staying in a motel.
I should hope not. The room service is dreadful.
Get to the showers.
You know, that paint's gonna take a bit of getting off.
Who'd want privileges like that?
Yeah. You know, I reckon just because you've got a few things going her way, the screws are gonna be even harder on her.
Well, I hope they are.
You wouldn't be a bit jealous now, would you, Doreen?
Why should I be? I would have thought you'd be the one who's jealous after finding out about her and Ken.
Oh, bloody men aren't worth worrying about anyway.
Don't think you're going to get any leeway with me because of this art nonsense. You work certain hours each day, and you'll make up for all the time you lost this morning before you get any more free time. Suppose you thought you were going to get it easy here. Splash a bit of paint on canvas and everyone's supposed to fall over you. Well, you're just another prisoner as far as I'm concerned.
I'm not pretending to be anything else.
Not everyone's allowed to arrive with the luggage you did. It's just another way to get special privileges, isn't it? I don't think you even care about art.
My painting is very important to me. There. Is that clean enough for you?
You're going to have to work very smartly to catch up on the time you've lost.
Yeah, well, I'll skip breakfast and my shower.
Oh, personal hygiene obviously isn't important to you. But you're going to find it hard working on an empty stomach.
I'll manage.
Oh, and don't worry about your hands. I'm sure your art won't suffer unduly.
Oh, that must be an interesting one.
Oh, it's Vincent's file. I was just going to record this morning's incident in it.
The paint on the floor, you mean?
Yes.
Well, I suppose she could have covered the floor with newspaper or something, but it's not worth reporting, is it?
She gets too much her own way. All this carry-on about her being an artist.
Well, apparently she has a lot of talent.
Well, she can't be that good. She only started painting 2 years ago.
What's that got to do with it?
Well, I thought that any talent worth developing needed to be trained from childhood. I used to have quite a flair for art when I was a child. If only I'd had the opportunity... Well, anyway, that thing she's working on at the moment is absolute rubbish. It doesn't look like anything.
Well, it's an abstract, isn't it?
Oh, it might as well be. But any child can smear paint on a canvas. I don't see how they can consider that talented.
Well, it all depends on your taste, I suppose. Well, I myself don't know anything about it.
Good morning, ladies. Oh,
morning, Captain Barton.
I've just been speaking with Mrs. Davidson. She's given me permission to see Lizzie Birdsworth.
Right, I'll take you through to her.
I've been real good, Captain Barton.
behaving myself all the time. Say my prayers night and morning, go around singing hymns, don't I, Mrs. Jackson?
Certainly do, Lizzie.
They say that the good get their reward, don't they?
In heaven, you mean?
Oh, I thought it might come a bit sooner than that.
Oh, there'll be other days out for you, Lizzie.
Beauty!
But I would like you to think seriously about when you're released from here.
I don't want to think about that.
I don't understand you, Lizzie. I really don't. You enjoy getting out for the day.
Yeah, but that's different. Afterwards, I can come back here where all my friends are.
So the outside world's a nice place for a visit, but you wouldn't want to live there, eh?
Yeah, that's right. It's like a little holiday, but it's nice to come home.
But this isn't a home, Lizzie. It's a jail, a place of punishment. There's a whole new life waiting for you on the outside.
I tried that, but I didn't like it.
But you'll have help this time. And you've got your compensation money. There's so much you can do.
I don't want the money. I'll give it to the Salvos. You can have the lot. Just so long as you take me out now and then.
You will need the money when you get out, Lizzie.
No, I won't, because I'm going to make sure I get straight back in again.
All right, Lizzie. I'll arrange to take you out again soon.
May I have a word with Dawn now, Mrs. Jackson?
All right then, Lizzie, but don't take too long.
Ta-ra, Captain Bart.
Bye-bye, Lizzie.
Bit of a hard case, our Lizzie.
Yes, I pray I can change her attitude before she's released again.
That'll take some doing.
Yes, don't I know it. Well, I better be going. I want to see Judy Bryant before she goes in for the operation.
Oh, that's today, isn't it?
Yes, she's very frightened. I only pray I can give her some comfort.
Hello, Miss Bryant. How are you feeling? Dr. East, your surgeon, remember? No, don't worry. The injection you've been given has made you a little sleepy.
I'm too scared to be sleepy.
Well, you're in good hands, even if I do say so myself. I have performed this operation before. Within a few weeks, you're going to have a whole new lease on life. The anaesthetist will be along shortly. Now, just relax. There's nothing to worry about.
Is it all right if I see Miss Bryant? I'm Captain Barton.
Oh, how do you do? I'm Dr. East, Miss Bryant's surgeon. She seems to be quite terrified. Try to give her some reassurance if you can.
Judy?
What are you doing here?
I thought you might like some company. Why don't we talk to the Lord about this? He's had a lot of experience in the past. Lord, we ask that you be with Judy at this time. I know that you love her. And I ask that she feel this now. I ask that she feel your love with her, Lord. We place this in your hands. I know that Judy will come out of this a strong and healthy woman. And I thank you now, Lord, in complete confidence that this is as it will be. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Nothing. All that praying and singing. Captain Barton hasn't even been here to tell me where I'm going to get out again. For all they care, I could rot.
Yeah, well, you did knock off half their takings last time, Lizzie. You can't blame them for not being too keen. They probably can't afford it. Listen, have you got a light?
They're supposed to forgive and forget. Lost all me buy-up privileges. What more do they want?
Hi, Lizzie. Any happier than you were in the garden?
Happier? Gorgeous. A bag full of laughs, I don't think.
Well, I haven't got any fags left, and I've lost me buy-up privileges.
Yeah, I'm getting low myself, actually.
Oh, Lizzie, look, you can have some of mine. I don't need much.
I've got a better idea. If we get hold of those buy-up orders, we could write things on them for you, Lizzie.
Hey, now, that is a good idea. Now would be a good time to do it, too, because the staff's busy.
Yeah, come on, Lizzie, in the staff room.
Hurry up, you lot. Oh. Vincent, you put in a request to be allowed to paint in the garden at this time.
Yeah, well, there's still some light.
Well, if you miss your dinner, that's your bad luck. The way food tastes here, I'd say it's good luck. Go on, get moving. You'd do well not to become too matey with that lot. Well, go on, hurry up. Get your materials if you still want to paint.
Where are you two going?
Just to the Dunny, Mrs. Jackson. I'm bursting. Come on, it's all right. Your orders haven't been made up yet. Yeah, well, if I just add something to a few of these lists, you'll probably end up with more than any of us.
And old Vinegar won't even know the difference.
Well, I hope she doesn't.
Of course she won't. Stop worrying.
Yeah, but what if she hasn't checked them yet?
Oh, she'll have checked them by now. We've really put one over the screws this time.
Of course, you know, Lizzie, it's probably a sin.
Well, I haven't got much out of being good. Anyway, the Lord helps them who help themselves.
Oh, look, come on. You're supposed to be really old. Oh, you stoop lower and move a bit slower. Beryl stirs the cauldron, the rest of you are dropping things in. Terrific.
They don't have to drive around and look like witches, do they?
Hey, Mrs. Jackson, do you reckon you could organise a visit from Ken Pierce? There's a few things I'd like to ask him about the play and that.
I'll see what I can do. Well, you two have taken your time.
Yeah, well, we went past Sharon's cell and she looked pretty upset, so we stopped to ask her what the matter was.
Oh, yeah, she looked real crook, Mrs. Jackson. I reckon it's because of Jude.
Well, I don't think there's any need to worry.
Oh, I don't know, Mrs. Jackson. The mills of God grind very slowly.
Oh, Struth, look, don't say that again. Listen, I need you two for some rehearsing. I haven't decided who's going to play the witches yet, but I reckon it's just about typecasting for you, Lizzie.
I'm not going to play a bloody witch. I want to be an angel.
Do you know how Judy is, Mrs. Jackson?
No, I'm sorry, I haven't heard.
It's a very serious operation, isn't it?
Yes, yes, I believe it is.
A great deal of it is up to her now. In my experience, once surgery is performed, recovery largely depends on the patient. An optimistic outlook helps immensely.
And she's not out of the woods, then?
No, not yet. Well, the operation itself was quite successful, but the physical trauma takes its toll on the body. But, as I say, her mind can do a lot to overcome that. She must be able to look forward to living a normal and healthy life again.
In Wentworth?
Oh, yes, and I suppose the prospect of being sent back there wouldn't help. Still, it is important that she has the will to go on.
Yes. Well, God can give her that.
Yes, no doubt he can. She'll be drifting in and out of sleep for several hours now. But feel free to stay as long as you wish.
Well, thank you.
Judy?
How'd it go?
It went well.
I'm gonna be all right.
Of course. I told you. The Lord's with you.
You know, I've never prayed before. It worked.
Yes, it worked.
I'm glad you're here.
I'll be around for a while.
Mom? This is Mr. Baldwin, our barrister.
Hello, Mrs. Williams. I am sorry to trouble you, but there are several things I have to discuss with you and Mrs. Simpson about the trial.
What's the good of talking about it?
Oh, it's very necessary. Mrs. Williams, first of all, I want you to know that you have quite a strong defense.
Who'll believe us?
It's my job to make them believe.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's time for my medication.
Oh, yes, of course. Your mother knows nothing about what's happened recently?
No, I didn't tell her about Michael. I thought the shock would be too much for her. She's still far from well.
Frankly, that won't go against us. She'll get quite a lot of sympathy. You need all the help you can get, Mrs. Simpson.
You mean things aren't going as well as you made out?
Not really. I just want to encourage her.
Yes, I'm glad you did.
Have you spoken to the press about your husband?
No. The reporters have been plaguing me, but I've just refused to speak to them.
Good. It'd be quite difficult if your association with Fletcher ever came to light. I believe a gag has been put on the media about the bombing. At least it should avoid any adverse reflections on your character.
To say how sorry we are.
Yes, thanks, Vera. Is Mrs. Davidson in?
Yes, she is.
Thank you.
There was no need for you to come back yet, Jim. You should have taken a few more days.
No, I wanted to come back.
Well, I don't think you're ready yet. Why don't you go away somewhere for a short while? Try to get some rest. You look exhausted.
Yeah, well, I can't sleep. All I do is just think of...
I know it must be very hard for you, but you must start trying to look ahead. You can't change the past.
Yeah, but it was my fault.
No, you must never let yourself think that way.
Well, it wouldn't have happened if it wasn't for Carolyn.
Carolyn? Carolyn Simpson?
Yes.
I'm afraid I don't understand what you mean.
Well, I put up the bail money for her. I was in love with her. Her husband became jealous. He teamed up with Jeff Butler and to get back at me, and because of that, Lena and the...
Oh, Jim.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson.
We'll talk about this again when you're ready. Now, please, go home and get some rest.
Thanks, Mrs. Davidson.
And the police have charged Michael Simpson as Butler's accomplice. Before being released on bail, Mrs. Simpson was held at Wentworth Detention Center for the manslaughter of her father. Simpson claims that his wife became romantically involved with Fletcher at the prison.
Oh, what a mess!
Yeah. Poor old Fletch.
Well, everything coming out like that isn't going to be too good for Carolyn's trial, either.
Oh, they'll be dead set against her.
Yeah. She'll probably end up in here for a long time.
Oh, and her mother too, probably. She won't like that. It'll kill her for sure.
Oh, it all sounds so awful.
Well, let's not get too bloody gloomy. I've had enough bad news for one day.
All right, Gilmore, back to work. And the rest of you.
I can't work today, Miss Bennett. I'm too worried about Judy.
Oh, really? Well, I know your type. Now get cracking, all of you.
Miss Bennett, have you seen anything of Fletch?
What if I have?
I was just wondering how he is.
How would you expect him to be?
Yeah, awful, isn't it? I expect Caroline's upset too.
You'll be able to ask yourself soon.
What do you mean?
Well, work it out for yourself. What jury would sympathize with her after what's happened?
But it shouldn't make any difference. She had nothing to do with the bomb.
Yes. You and Simpson are rather similar, come to think of it. You both think you're a cut above everyone else. Well, we'll soon get that idea out of your head.
Oh, bitch.
Oh, you said it. Not too far from the truth, though, is it? And they do think you're a bit of a celebrity. Just remember, as far as we're concerned, you're the same as the rest of us.
Wendy, do you have that call for me yet? Who? David Alston? Well, did he say why he wanted to see me? I see. Well, you better send him in and put that call through while I'm waiting. Mr. Douglas, please. Erica Davidson here. Oh, Ted, sorry to bother you, but I put a call through the department the other day about an officer replacement, and I haven't had a reply. We're getting rather desperate here, and I wondered if you could hurry things along. Come in. Oh, that'd be wonderful. Yes, it'd be a great help. Well, I'll call you again when I'm not quite so busy. Yes. Goodbye. Sorry about that.
Mr. Austin, isn't it?
Yes, David Austin. I'm delighted to meet you, Mrs. Davidson.
Of course, I know you by reputation, Mr. Austin. Please sit down.
Ah, thank you very much.
I understand you're Kerry Vincent's agent.
Yes, yes, that's right. Kerry's an incredibly talented girl. Have you seen any of her paintings?
Yes, one or two. I like them very much.
Well, I'm convinced that she's going to be one of the most sought-after artists in the country.
You certainly have faith in your clients.
Well, I've been in the business long enough to recognize real talent when I see one. Now, the reason for my visit, because I know you must be very busy, would it be possible for Kerry to attend her exhibition?
Yes, she had spoken to me about it, but I didn't realize she'd have enough paintings for an exhibition.
Well, it's a mixed showing. Two or three of Kerry's paintings are on display with those of other artists. But even so, being part of a major exhibition like this is a very big step in her career.
Yes, I understand that. I have spoken to the department about her leave, and I don't think it should be too much trouble. Is this her first exhibition?
Well, apart from a rather obscure one a couple of years ago, I happened to attend quite by chance and immediately recognized her potential.
She's very fortunate to have been seen by such a respected member of the art world.
Ah, Mrs. Davidson, I feel that I'm the one who's fortunate. It's a great honor to discover such a talent like this. Would it be possible for me to see Kerry while I'm here?
Yes, of course. I'll take you to an interview room. Oh, by the way, did you see the Russian exhibition of old masters at the National Gallery?
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. In fact, I went a number of times.
Oh, I wish I could have gone more than once. Some of those paintings I could have looked at for hours. There was one I particularly loved. A girl's face lit by candlelight. Positively glowed.
Ah, well, I can see that you appreciate the old masters much more than the modern painters, Mrs. Davidson.
To be honest, yes, I do. Kerry's work, I know, is far from traditional.
Well, she is developing her own style. In fact, she's experimenting with new techniques all the time, you know.
Oh, Miss Bennett, would you take Kerry Vincent to the interview room, please? Mr. Austin wishes to speak to her.
Certainly, Mrs. Davidson.
Thank you. Now, you do realize you're on the threshold of being recognized by the public. This is when all the nice things start to happen. Recognition of your talent, financial reward, all those.
Just the chance to keep on paying, that's all I want. Those other things don't mean much in here.
Yes, well, we'll get you out of here as soon as possible. The more your talent's recognized, the more lever we've got, you see.
I will be able to go to the exhibition, won't I?
Yes, I spoke to Mrs. Davidson. She said that permission is purely a formality.
Oh, that's great.
Now, have you got enough time to paint? Now, this new painting, do you want that to go to the exhibition?
Yes, it must.
Well, will it be ready?
I'll make sure it is. Listen, is it possible to get a lamp for my cell? I mean, it's so poorly lit and they turn out the light so early.
Yes, I'm sure we can arrange that.
Time's up.
Already?
I can't afford any more time. I have other things to do.
Well, why don't you just run off and do them and we can keep on talking?
It's against the rules. Come on, Vincent.
Oh, is he? Okay, Kerry, I'll see you soon. And don't worry about anything. You're in good hands.
Thanks, David. Thanks a lot.
See you later. Bye. Well, it must make a pleasant change, having someone like Kerry in here. I hope you're looking after her.
I treat them all the same. Now, I'll send an officer to escort you back to the reception. Get moving, Vincent.
And I'm sort of excited and scared at the same time.
You don't have to put them on display.
Oh, but I want to. I want to know what people think.
And I'm looking forward to getting out of here for a day, too.
I don't know what they're thinking of letting you out.
I have to get this finished in time. I think it's the best thing I've ever done. Do you like it?
Not much. Abstract art's a lot of pretentious rubbish.
Oh, but don't you see, I'm trying to show what I feel as well as what I see. Things like joy and pain.
Pain? I thought you said you enjoyed painting.
Oh, I do. It just takes a lot of pleasure to wipe out the pain you've already suffered.
Oh, I took Vincent's visitor back to reception.
Good. I hope he's not going to be waltzing in and out of here too often, filling her head with the idea she should be treated better than anyone else.
Well, they say she's very talented, Vera.
Well, her agent keeps beating that drum, of course. But I know something about art myself. Look at her background. How could she be a great artist?
I don't really see that background has anything to do with it. A lot of the greats weren't necessarily well educated, you know.
It isn't a matter of education. It's a matter of sensitivity. And none of the animals here, including Vincent, would have enough sensitivity to cover a pinhead. But apparently we're to pamper to Vincent, as if we haven't got enough to do as it is.
Oh, yes. I wonder if Mrs. Davidson's done anything about a replacement for Mr. Fletcher.
Yes, you'd think she'd get onto the department and insist they do something about it.
Where shall I find Sharon Gilmore, Miss Bennet?
Either in her cell or the laundry, I think.
Thank you.
Now hurry up with that.
Aren't you supposed to be working, Gilmore?
I can't, Mrs. Davidson. I'm too worried about Judy. I just can't concentrate on work today.
I've been in touch with the hospital, and Bryant has been successfully operated on. There's no need for you to worry any longer.
You will let me visit her, won't you? She'll want to see me.
No, I'm afraid that's not possible.
But she hasn't any other friends. If someone visits her, it'll help her get better. Now, if I could go each day, it'd cheer her up.
There is no way I can spare an officer to take you out. Besides, in view of your record, I am not prepared to allow you the privilege of going out. For any reason.
But it's for Judy's sake, not mine.
The answer is no. Now, I suggest you go and do some work. Join the women for the recreation period. After that, you are to work in the laundry. Understand?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
If I hear any more about Brian's progress, I'll let you know.
Hi.
Oh, hi.
You're lucky to have a big cell all to yourself.
Yeah, I need a bit of room for my materials.
Must get a bit lonely, though.
No, I don't mind.
But wouldn't you rather have someone with you at night?
Not really. I'll be getting a lamp for the cell soon, so I'll be able to work as late as I want to. Probably get on someone else's nerves.
You had a visitor before, didn't you?
What? Oh, yeah, David Austin.
Your boyfriend, is he?
No, he's my agent. I'm having an exhibition. Some of my paintings are going to be shown, and I'm allowed out. Isn't that great?
I wasn't allowed out to see Judy.
Yeah, well, it's probably because of David. He can be very persuasive.
And I suppose he'll want you to show your gratitude.
What?
On the day's out. He'll expect you to come across, won't he? I'm sure he's interested in more than your paintings.
I don't have to work on the game anymore, Sharon. David gets a percentage of any of my paintings he sells, and that's all he gets.
Don't you like him?
Yeah, I like him a lot. I'm just not interested in him in that way. Or any other man, for that matter.
I thought that might be the case. I hoped it was.
I'm sorry, Sharon. The reason I say I'm not interested in any man at the moment is because my painting is all I care about. I don't need anything else. So how about letting me get on with it, huh?
Well, tell Officer Meadows to take him to the recreation room. Oh, well, I'm glad you've arrived. I had the feeling I was running this place single-handed.
Huh? Has it been a busy morning?
Oh, visitors coming in at all times. Ken Pierce has just arrived to see Smith. If I had my way, they would get no visitors at all.
Oh, I think it's good the way Ken's got them interested in producing a play. Gives them something constructive to think about.
Well, I hope it's nothing like that play they put on last Christmas.
It's Shakespeare, would you believe?
They don't understand a word of it.
You are in a bad way, aren't you?
There's so much work to get through. Oh, Mrs. Davidson, Ken Pierce arrived to see Smith. I assumed it was all right.
Yes, of course. I think he's been a good influence on the women.
Well, I wonder what sort of influence the women were on his daughter.
Oh, very good, I believe. Apparently the experiment was quite successful.
Mrs. Davidson's for you.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Jackson. Erica Davidson speaking. Yes. Oh, good. That will take some of the strain off us. Thank you. Goodbye. That was the department. They're sending a temporary replacement officer from Pentridge.
A man?
Well, this is no time to quibble, Miss Bennet. His name is Stewart, Jock Stewart.
Oh, thank goodness we've got someone.
Why they couldn't find a woman, I don't know. Although I suppose we have to be grateful for what we get.
I'm really glad you're staying on with the drama group, Bree.
Yeah, well, I don't know if it'll be any good or not. There's still quite a few things I don't really understand.
What are they?
Oh, God. I don't want her tuning into every word. Hang on a minute. Hey,
you two see if we can keep her off our backs for a while?
Oh, yeah. You're right, Pete. Ah, Miss Bennet, we was wondering.
Wondering what?
About the buyout.
Yeah, about the buyout.
What about it?
Well, they're still on, aren't they? We thought they might have been cancelled on account of the staff shortage.
You don't have to worry about it, Birdsworth. You weren't getting anything anyway.
I know that. I was just thinking about the others.
Yeah. So it's still on, is it, Miss Bennet?
Of course it is.
Oh, another thing, Miss Bennet.
Later, Anderson.
We shouldn't have gone on about the buyout. She's
well,
got suspicious.
I couldn't think of anything else to say, could I?
What about this new girl, Kerry Vincent? They reckon she's artistic. Think she'd be any good in the drama group?
No, I don't think Kerry gave up the time from her painting. Actually, I didn't even know she was here yet.
Yeah, she arrived the other day. Is she really as good as they reckon?
She's got a lot of potential, but she still needs tuition.
Well, why was she transferred?
Her art teacher can see her here. He wouldn't go all the way to Barnhurst.
You seem to know quite a bit about her.
Yeah, well, when I heard about her, I did quite a bit of lobbying to get her into the metropolitan area.
Mm. You've met her a few times then?
Yeah, just, well, once or twice. In fact, now she's here, I'd like to say hello to her. Miss Bennet, any chance of me seeing Kerry Vincent?
Yes, I don't see why not. Come with me.
Thanks. I hope what I said about the play will be of help, B. I'll catch up with you soon.
Yeah.
So, see, there is something between him and Kerry. He couldn't wait to see her. And she's already had one visit today. I wonder Vera'd let her have another one.
Oh, she's just trying to get up Bee's nose.
Well, I don't give a damn anyway.
That Kerry seems to get just what she wants, doesn't she? Even from Vera.
I don't know. Vera came down on her pretty hard yesterday.
Yeah, but she's been pretty chatty with her today. Wonder what made the difference.
What are you getting at?
You know, Vera, there's only one way you ever get her on side.
You mean by lagging?
Oh, she wouldn't, would she?
I wouldn't put it past her. I reckon that's how she got all her other privileges, by sucking up to the screws.
I did that a long time ago.
What are you doing here? I thought you were seeing Pierce.
Yeah, I was. I just left. Oh, what are you doing?
Just having a look at some of this great talent I keep hearing about.
But you don't like my painting.
Not much. This is the best of them, in my opinion.
You can have it if you like.
I didn't say I wanted it.
Well, I just thought that... All right.
I used to paint myself when I was younger.
Did you? It's a great feeling, isn't it? Nothing makes me feel quite so happy. For a while, nothing else seems to exist but the painting you're working on.
Yes.
I'll probably paint over most of those.
Will you paint over this?
Yeah, might as well. Say, buy a new canvas. I'm working on a different style altogether now.
It'd be a shame.
If you like it, take it. There's no skin off my nose.
Well, I do like the colours.
Then, for heaven's sake, take it. If you want to get it framed, David Austin will do it for you. There you go. There's his address.
Thank you.
Wonder when old Fletcher's coming back.
Not for a while, I wouldn't reckon. He'd be feeling pretty lousy. I know I would.
Yeah, poor bugger. I was praying for him last night.
Thought you chucked all that holy stuff in.
Oh, I don't know. Sometimes it's nice to think someone up there's wondering what's happening to you.
Yeah. I believe in God. At least I think I do. What about you, Bee?
Hmm? What's the matter, Bee? You're not with it.
Well, I'm just sick of hearing you prattle on, that's all.
What's the matter with her?
Well, I think it's because of Ken and Kerry.
Oh, that Kerry better watch out if Bee's got it in for her.
Mm.
Come on, Bee, back up, love.
Oh, I'm just tired, Lizzie. You had a fag, Lizzie?
Oh, you know I haven't got any left.
Neither have I.
Well, don't worry, it's the buy-up today.
Yeah. Well, hope I get all my stuff.
Well, it should be all right, as long as Vera hasn't cottoned on.
She won't, she's too dense.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me.
Be with you in just a moment. Good morning.
Good morning. I'd like to get this framed.
It's Miss Bennett, isn't it?
That's right, Vincent. I mean, Kerry recommended you. This is the painting I'd like framed.
Ah. One of Kerry's early ones.
I said I liked it and she gave it to me. I thought seeing you knew her work so well, you might be able to pick a frame for it.
Yes, of course. Very sensible of you. You know, I don't think Kerry realizes what her paintings will be worth in a while.
She was going to paint over it.
Well, that's typical of Kerry. Perhaps I should rescue the other ones before she manages to destroy those too. You know, although some of these early paintings are fairly naive, I think you'll find that they'll be of great interest as she becomes better known. I think you're very lucky to own one, Miss Bennett.
I only took it to please her, really. She seemed quite eager that I have it.
Yes, of course. Perhaps you'd like an invitation to Kerry's exhibition.
When will the frame be ready?
Tomorrow morning.
Mrs. Jackson, have you seen Miss Bennett?
No, I haven't.
Well, I hope she's not ill. I don't remember her being late before.
No, it is unlike her.
Well, especially as we're so short-staffed.
I'm sorry I'm late, Mrs. Davidson. I got held up.
Well, I'm just glad you're here, Miss Bennett. I think it would be better if the buy-up were held before morning work instead of the usual time today.
Very well, Mrs. Davidson.
And because of Vincent's exhibition, she's to be allowed off work to finish her painting.
Very well. Now, Birdsworth's off the buy-up list this week, isn't she?
Yes, that is correct. Well, I'll let you get on with it.
Is everything all right, Vera?
Oh, how do you mean?
Well, you just said that you were held up.
Look, my bus was late, that's all. Let me check those buy-up lists again. Come on, let's get it over and done with. Come on, you lot, move along to the recreation room. The buy-up's this morning, not this afternoon.
Oh, beauty!
I've already told you, Birdsworth, there's nothing for you.
Did you arrange for the framing all right, dear?
It's Miss Bennett to you, Vincent. These weren't on your original list, Anderson. No. You thought you'd get away with that little trick, didn't you? Well, don't ever try it again. Birdsworth has lost her buy-up privilege, and it's not up to you to make it up for her.
We can order anything we like.
Only up to a certain value, Smith. And you can think yourself lucky that you don't lose next week's buy-ups for this little stunt. You don't have to work in the laundry today. You're free to go and paint in the garden.
Thanks.
The rest of you get to work.
Not a bloody thing.
Well, don't worry, Lizzie. I said that we would share ours with you.
Yeah, but I should have had my own stuff.
What I'd like to know is how they got onto it.
I think that's pretty obvious.
What do you mean?
Come on, how much evidence do you need?
Kerry?
Of course. Look at all the special treatment she's getting. First of all, that big cell all to herself. And a lot less work than we've got to do. And two visits in the one day. You know what Vera's usually like about that. Then what about the two of them this morning? A bit too friendly, I thought.
Yeah, well, Vera did whisper something to her.
Then Kerry must be lagging.
Well, then we'll have to do something about it.
What?
Well, the only thing she seems to care about is her precious bloody painting. Maybe we'll have to put a spoke in that particular wheel.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still. shine.